More than 600 young people, different young people, have come to our 8 national festivals. Every year, about a third of the young people who come to preach, this year 110, a third of those are returning young preachers. Two-thirds brand new. Every year, about 10% of our preachers are preaching their very first sermon. And it all started on June the 23rd, 2008, in a casual conversation with friends of ours at the Lilly Endowment in Indianapolis. At the end of the conversation, they said to me, "You write a project, we'll fund it, and you can start in 6 months." That is why June 23rd is what we call AOP Day. And this year, in 9 cities around the country, on June the 23rd, we will be hosting events. And we hope that many of you will drive a short way or a long way to attend an event where we celebrate the Academy of Preachers, where we pray for these young people, where we hear a young person preach, and where we pledge to support it with a check or money order or online. You can read all about that in our newsletters and online. But it all started on June the 23rd, and about 2 weeks later, after I'd been asked to do this, I attended an ecumenical conversation at Pax Christi Roman Catholic Church here in Lexington, Kentucky. It was a small group of people. We went around the circle and everybody introduced themselves and described their ministry. And in about 3 sentences, I described what the Lilly Endowment had asked me to do. And after the conversation was over, a priest, whom I did not know, tapped me on the shoulder and said, "I'm very interested in what you're trying to do. I would like to be a part of it." Turns out it was Father Martin Leinbach sitting right here in the front table. And I'm here tonight to honor him and 3 other people who helped us start this 8 years ago. As it turns out, Father Martin was the ecumenical officer of the Archdiocese of Louisville, Kentucky. And he said, "Let me talk to my archbishop and see if he might be interested in this." It turns out Archbishop Joseph Kurtz was very interested, so much so that for 2 years in a row, he hosted our event at the Cathedral of the Assumption in downtown Louisville, Kentucky. And then he collaborated with me to write, I can't believe we actually did this, we wrote the Pope, you know, Francis, and asked him to host the first international festival of young preachers in Rome. We watched the video last night of that invitation. He's written us back. But it's not the last word, I believe, on this international idea. But I'm here tonight to thank Martin Leinbach, and in just a minute, I'm going to ask him to come up and stand beside me, and also another person, and I'm going to present both of them a gift. Martin served on our board of advisors at first, and then on our board of directors, and he began to bring young preachers like Shane to our festivals. And he opened a great wide door to the whole Catholic world that we have gone marching straight through. And this year, we have the largest number of Roman Catholic young preachers at our festival that we've ever had. We're making plans for a national festival of young Roman Catholic preachers in 2019. And I want Martin to be there. Martin, I love you. God sent you to that meeting. God inspired you. God bless you for our collaboration. May God bless our work together and the whole family of God. Thank you very much. Across town from Martin was another preacher, a disciple of Christ Christian Church pastor by the name of David Emery. I did not know David, but one of my associates at the time did. Lee Huckleberry, our first executive director, introduced me to David. And David immediately became an advocate, a supporter, a donor, and a host. And when we needed a place to set up operations, open an office, our first office, David said, "Come to Middletown Christian Church." And they gave us the prime space right off of the entrance to their foyer at their beautiful building in East Louisville. And he began to advocate for us, not only in his congregation among donors and among young preachers. We've had a whole stream of young preachers from their church preach at our event. He gathered a group of people, members of his church in a private home, and asked me to come and talk about the vision. And I did. If you want me to do that in your church, I'll do it. And we took two young preachers with us who gave their testimony just like we've heard tonight. I made the appeal. I did not know these people. But at the end, Dave and I together asked them to make a pledge. And one lady, whom I did not know, pulled out a pledge card and wrote these numbers on the pledge card. 50,000,000,000. You got it? I looked at that and said, well, this must be a mistake. She's got one too many zeros here. But no. Because God touched her heart and imagination with the same vision that you have received here tonight. A vision for influencing an entire generation of preachers, not just in America, but around the world. David has been my prayer partner, my confidant, my friend, my partner. David, I honor you. I thank you. These two men have been key people in launching what's happening here tonight. Now, before I ask them to come up, I want to say just a brief word about two people who had planned to be here tonight but could not. Tim Malloy grew up a Baptist but is now a Catholic, is the owner and CEO of the Paratus PR public relations firm in Louisville. It's really a lobbying firm, and they spend a great deal of time in Frankfurt on behalf of clients. They have fine offices. They have a wonderful staff. And one day, his friend, our executive director, Lee Huckleberry, took me into their great conference room and asked me to describe the vision that we had. With him were designers and several account reps. And I talked about the vision that God had given me, that God had inspired the Lillian Endowment to endorse. And this is what Tim said to me. I had never met him before. He said, "I love this vision." He said, "You know, Dwight, I make a lot of money off of customers and clients who aren't doing anywhere near the important kind of work that you're doing. I want to be your marketing firm. I don't care what you pay me. I want to take your brand and make it a national brand." A few days later, he handed me a contract that had all the information on it except the amount of the contract. And he said to me, "You write in any figure you want." A few days later, and of course I did, and it wasn't one of those five with four zeros after it either, I'll tell you that. 2 weeks later, I went back to their office to take a preview at the design, the branding design. Now, those of you who know me know that I've got lots of ideas. And I had an idea about what our design should look like, what our brand should look like. And I had described it to their team of designers. But when I went to that conference room and they unfolded this red and green bubbles, I said, "Where did this come from?" And the young designer, whom I had never met and is now working in Miami, Florida, another Roman Catholic, she said, "When I think of preaching, I think of inspiration. And when I think of inspiration, I think of the inspiration bubbles that appear over heads in cartoons. That's where it came from." Of course, I loved it immediately. We accepted it. They began to design all of the work, all of the designs that we still use today. And I want to say to you, Tim Malloy, if you're listening tonight, we have a national brand that is powerful, distinctive, clear, and known throughout all of the religious world in the United States. I have people come up to me all the time and talk to me about our brand, our colors, our script, and of course the inspiration bubbles. And when my team and our local designers, when we get together and talk about what things ought to look like on screens and on print, I always tell them the same thing. Make sure there are lots of bubbles on the design. I want to thank you, Tim, for what you did for us to get started. God used you, God touched you, and God used your team to give us the kind of brand, the kind of look, the kind of visual message that has helped us become a little bit of what God has intended for us to become. He had a young woman on his staff, fresh out of Murray State University, who had grown up listening to preaching. Her name was Carissa Acree. Her father, a Baptist preacher in Fulton, Kentucky. I know where Fulton is. I grew up in Murray, Kentucky, just down the road from Fulton. He assigned her to our account. She became the beautiful face of our planning and our teamwork. She had the nerve, as a 23-year-old, fresh out of college grad, to come up to me and tell me what to do. It took me just a couple of weeks to start saying, "Yes, ma'am, okay, we will do exactly what you want." Because she had vision, she had commitment. It wasn't for her just a professional gig. It was a calling rooted in her own many years of listening to preaching. Carissa, if you're listening tonight, I still love you. I honor you. I thank you. I praise God for the investment that you made in the lives of these young people who are gathered here today. We are here tonight because of these four people, because of this simple vision of giving a space and a place for young people. Most of the time when young people gather for religious inspiration, this is what happens. They gather in rooms large and small, and they sit and listen to a handful of name speakers wow them with their stories and skill. Our mission is to flip that pattern. We create space and a place for every young preacher to bring your voice, your skill, your ambition, your calling. We give you the microphone, and we sit down while you stand up. We listen, we pray, we learn, we affirm, and we celebrate what God is doing in your life, what God is going to do through your life, what God is going to do among the whole United States because of the gifts and calling God has put upon you. And I want to thank these four people and ask the two that are here tonight to come up and stand beside me and receive a token of our appreciation. Let's give them a great greeting. We have prepared for them, I want to say that Tyler Best, Tyler, stand up. Tyler Best is AOP 12 out of the University of Evansville, now at Asbury Seminary. He's been working long and hard all week. He designed and prepared a gift memorial book for each of these four. It contains on the front the image of our very first Preachapalooza magazine. And then on the inside, a pictorial history of the 8 years of the Academy of Preachers. We got it in the mail at 3 o'clock this afternoon. But when Tyler handed it to me and I thumbed through it, I gave glory to God. Amen. Just looking at all the pictures of some of you, inspired me all over again. It gave me fresh energy, fresh vision, fresh commitment. I even got my checkbook out and wrote a new check to the Academy of Preachers, which is what some of you need to do tonight before we leave this place. David, God bless you. God bless you. Here is your gift. Martin, God bless you. Here's your gift. I hope it inspires you. I hope you being here tonight, that you go back inspired, thankful that God somehow pulled you in to this great movement of God. I want to for us to have a word of prayer. After we pray, the choir is going to sing. The ensemble is going to sing. And then we want to invite all of you, I want you to stay right there, don't leave, outside because we have dessert for all of you. I want to challenge you, every person here tonight, to become a mentor, an advocate, a volunteer, a member, a donor to this movement that we call the Academy of Preachers. You can make a difference in the life of some young preacher. You can make a difference in the life of some congregation through that preacher. You can make a difference in a whole city through that congregation, through that preacher. God can use you as a mentor, as a volunteer, as an advocate, as a donor, as a member. And I challenge you to hear the word of God tonight in these sentences. Now let's all bow our heads and humble our hearts. I'm going to speak a few words. But what I hope you hear tonight is the Word of God speaking to you. Almighty and everlasting God, maker of heaven and earth, redeemer of the whole world, a present help in a time of trouble. We worship you tonight. We honor you. We give you glory. We give you praise. Thank you, God, for bringing us here tonight. We confess tonight that you have a purpose in us being here tonight. Speak to us. Give us a fresh vision. Renew our spirits. Encourage us. Show us a way forward. Lift us up out of the trouble that we're in. Give us direction in the confusion of our lives. Thank you for the young preachers who are here tonight. Thank you for the inspiration and hope and encouragement that they bring to all of us who have been in the work for so long. We thank you for the Lord Jesus Christ, who calls us one and all across all the boundaries that we spend so much time putting up. We want to hear your call. We want to feel your spirit. We want to do your work. We want to preach your gospel. Thank you for bringing us here tonight. Bless us as we depart. Give us a great work to do in the days ahead, that we might all of our days find ourselves in the center of your will for the glory of God and the common good. I pray on behalf of all of us here tonight, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, and all the people said,
Amen.
Amen.